What's up, party people? Welcome to another exciting edition of...
The Vlog of Awesomeness. Wait, what happened to my voice?
Ahem. That's better. You wouldn't know this right now, but I'm doing this in my pajamas. First thing I want to address is, in my fan suggestions last week, there was a fan suggestion that I had a little miscommunication with. I've since then talked to the person. Everything's cool. Everything is kosher. But I should have double-checked what this person meant by it. And I just want to make it public that I apologize and it won't happen again. So now I want to present a new segment that I like to call...
Things I Didn't Know Existed.
That's right. I found a couple of things this week that I didn't know existed. My first discovery was when I was at work the other day. Check it out. What's up, party people? Look what I found at the Walmart. I did not know these existed. I'm very happy. I know Lego makes a lot of sets, but I really did not know that these existed. And they're stupid expensive, though. I can't afford them. I do have a birthday coming up, you know, on November 4th, just in case you guys are curious of what to get me. It's a pretty good idea. But why are they so expensive? What happened to the Legos from back in the day when they were random colors and random sizes and the possibilities were endless? I could build skyscrapers and I could knock them down like I was Godzilla, and then I could rebuild them and I could knock them down again. Why? Because that's what I did when I was a kid. I was kind of destructive. My next discovery is this fruit called the grapple. Thanks, Max, for turning me on to this and not telling me where I could find these. A grapple is an apple that tastes like a grape. Why did I not know these existed? I'm not the hugest apple fan, but I would totally tear these up. Once again, birthday's coming up on November 4th if you're looking to get me a tasty treat. Look into these. The next thing I want to address is the loss of the Tridge sunglasses. Those of you who know me, know that I've been sporting a pretty awesome pair of shades the last few months that I found on at the Tridge when I was taking maternity pictures with my friend Seth and Allie. These sunglasses had some meaning to me. Now I know these look like a regular pair of sunglasses, but, and I'm gonna throw this disclaimer out, if you have a weak heart, you may wanna look away. I don't think sunglasses are supposed to do this. So I found a few videos, I found a few pictures, and I compiled them together to make a nice little tribute to the Tridge sunglasses. Enjoy.
How do I say goodbye to what we had? The good time that made us laugh, I'll wake them back. I thought we'd get to see forever, but forever's gone away. It's so hard to say goodbye to yesterday.
So Tridge sunglasses, you treated me well. You kept the sun out of my eyes, and you made me look pretty darn awesome. And for that, I thank you. Now it's time for you to go. Be free. Alright, I'm over it. So now it's time for everybody's favorite segment, fan suggestions. First one comes from Will. He wanted me to talk about Obama. There's two things in this world that I don't talk about. A, religion. B, politics. I don't know enough about these subjects to go into detail. Plus, they cause a lot of controversy, and I'd just rather not get into all that drama. So all I'm going to say about Obama is he's the President of the United States. The next one comes from Dan. He asks, if you could be any animal for 48 hours, which one would it be and why? Now, are we talking real animal or are we talking mythology? Because if we're talking mythology, I think I'd like to be a phoenix, a bird engulfed in flames. And then when I die, I rise from my ashes once again. How awesome would that be? Now, if we're talking real animal, I think I'd like to go with a shark. Why? Because I'm not the greatest swimmer in the world, but if I was a shark, then I could swim. Plus, I'd have them awesome teeth, and people would fear me. I don't know why that appeals to me. It just does. Thanks, Dan, for the suggestion. Next one comes from Jamie. She says, what's the weirdest thing that you've ever put in your mouth and not eaten? Well, we gotta go back to my days at Long John Silver's for that one. One time, I was hard up for some cash. So all the employees I was working with, they scrounged up all their loose change and everything that they could find, which in the end only ended up being $8. But it was enough for me at that time. So the challenge was to get the $8 is that I had to take a very small ball of caked on grease from the bottom of the vat and I had to stick it in my mouth and I had to chew on it not once, not twice, but three times. I earned that $8 that day. Thanks, Jamie. Keep them coming. The last one comes from Amy. She's a loyal fan who's been with us since the Awesome Acousticness days. She wanted me to talk about Zach Galifianakis. I enjoy Zach Galifianakis in the movies that he does, but where I really enjoyed him was back in the day when he was sitting at a piano and he's just telling these one-liner jokes and he's telling them with such a serious face. If y'all don't know what I'm talking about, I'm sure YouTube is full of them. Go check them out. I thought they were pretty funny. I want to thank everybody for your suggestions. I know there was a few that I didn't get to this week, and there's a reason for that. Because I want to create a whole vlog of awesomeness with nothing but your fan suggestions. How great would that be, really? So make sure you keep them coming. Throw them down in the comments below. You can hit us up over on the social medias. So that's going to be all for this week's vlog of awesomeness. Rest in peace, Tridge Sunglasses. And until next week, keep on rocking. And KCCO.